because who isn't a fan of skin-on-skin cuddles? Greetings, fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com, and today I would like to talk about the reason why I don't wear pajamas anymore. Growing up, my family put a lot of stock in pajamas. My mom would buy me a new pair every couple of months, and I was encouraged to both wear them around the house and, of course, to sleep in them. So I got used to it, and I didn't think anything of it. But I remember feeling really uncomfortable every time I moved around in bed, which is a lot because apparently I'm a very active sleeper, and my pajama leg or my sleeve would roll up, and I had to keep pushing it down again, which doesn't sound like a big deal. But when it's cold and you found your perfect comfy little warm spot, you don't really want to move just because your pant leg is crawled up, but you also don't want to leave it there because part of your leg is now cold. Admittedly, much of this habit of wearing pajamas to sleep was born out of necessity, since we didn't have central heating or any air conditioning system around the house. We definitely didn't have any electric blankets back then. So when it got cold, I didn't want to take off my already warm pajamas to crawl into a cold bed. Later in the year, when the weather got a little bit warmer, I simply switched out my long fleecy pajamas for shorter cotton ones. I didn't really think that I had any other option at the time, since I'd never really heard of anyone sleeping naked, and I was living in my family home, so after we were all finished with work or school or whatever we were doing, we'd come home, have a shower, everyone would get changed into their pajamas, and we would kind of lounge around the house, watch TV together, talk, have dinner, that sort of thing. Oh yeah, and did I mention that all this time, not only am I wearing multiple layers, so I've got an undershirt, I've got my regular pajama shirt on top, I'm also wearing my bra underneath it all, which now sounds crazy to me since I never wear a bra anymore. But if you have seen my other video that I'll link up here where I talk about why I gave up bras, you'll understand why this is so crazy. Anyway, I didn't actually give any of this much thought until I moved out of the house and started dating someone who liked to sleep in the nude. They said that I should try it, and they gave me a long list of benefits as to why. Of course, they also use a lot of positive reinforcement to sweeten the deal, because who isn't a fan of skin-on-skin cuddles? Anyway, the rest is history. Even though I'm no longer with that person anymore, needless to say, I found a whole heap of very convincing reasons to stick with the habit. Here are my top 5 benefits that I've found come with foregoing pajamas in bed. 1. You enjoy a better quality of sleep. Wearing clothes while you sleep increases your chances of getting snagged or bundled up in a whole bunch of different layers, whether it's clothes or bedsheets, while you sleep. When you toss and turn, you could get your pants hiked up or pulled down. A couple of times, I've even woken up to having my shirt almost strangling me. It's not a good feeling, and it makes for a really restless sleep. Sleep is very important. That's the time when hormones get released into your bloodstream to manage your appetite, maintain your immune system, and repair cell damage. If your clothing is restricting blood flow, it can get in the way of your physical health. 2, it allows your skin and your privates to breathe. Your skin is your body's largest organ, and in a lot of ways, the most important one. It needs to have contact with the air around it to stay healthy and do its job. The same is true of your genitals. Because they tend to be warmer than the rest of your body, they need good, let's say, ventilation. If you keep them hidden away in tight, warm underwear and pants all day and all night, you're risking things like yeast infections and other nasties that thrive in a warm, moist environment. Testicles are especially vulnerable to too much restriction, as when they stay in clothes that are too warm or too tight for them for too long, it can lead to a lower sperm count, and in some cases, even testicular cancer. Something like that is very serious, and if you can avoid it by taking off your clothes while you sleep, why wouldn't you? 3, if you sleep next to another human, skin-on-skin cuddling releases a lot of feel-good hormones. We all know that touching and hugging other humans is good for us. It releases oxytocin, which makes us feel safe and secure. It also releases dopamine, that makes us feel pleasure. And it lowers cortisol, a hormone that causes stress and high blood pressure. Not only does this combination make you happier and healthier, but it also boosts your sex life, for obvious reasons, which is also a very healthy thing. 4, you stay cooler while you sleep. Wearing too many layers, whether it's clothing or bed sheets, around your body while you sleep increases your body heat. Now, you might think that's a good thing, but warmer skin has been linked to more activity in the area of the brain that regulates sleep. This means that the cooler your body is while you're in bed, the easier it will be for you to fall asleep and stay asleep. Another interesting fact is that having a slightly lower body temperature while you sleep boosts your metabolism, increases your body's ability to burn fat, and decreases your chance of diabetes. Not a bad price to pay for feeling a little bit chilly. And 5, it's less clothing to own and wash. As a minimalist, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the fact that sleeping naked means you don't need to own pajamas. That's one less pair of clothing you need to buy, store, and wash. Not to mention, if you don't have pajamas, it means you'll have to put regular clothes on the second you wake up, and after you have a shower at the end of the day. This will make you much less likely to lounge around the house after coming home from work or during a weekend. If you're already dressed, you're much more likely to leave the house and go on an adventure. At the very least, you won't be able to use "I'm too comfy" as an excuse for saying no to someone's invitation. Anyway, those were my reasons for giving up pajamas. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. If you found this useful, please give this video a thumbs up and share it with others. If you enjoy videos about minimalism and simple living, then subscribe and ring the bell, because I make a new one every single Sunday. I also make secret monthly videos over on my Patreon account and do live Q&As, so if that's something you're interested in, head on over there and support the channel. If you're interested in starting a lifestyle that's similar to mine and you'd like some help, I offer coaching sessions that you can book for free at happyandauthentic.com. Whatever you decide, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you when I see you. And now, please allow me to thank my patrons, Eric Gindes, Don Rivers, Lizmar Santiago, and Tania Danilenko. You guys really support this channel, and whether you stick around or not, I would like to take this time to say a heartfelt thank you.